Erica, it is absolutely fantastic to have you here for us at Collectomania. Have you been enjoying it so far?
I have been. This has been really fun. I'm like smiling ear to ear. It's fun meeting everybody. You know, it's fun meeting fans of Bones. And everybody's here nice. And it's been fun meeting the other actors and wrestlers and other athletes here. And I'm having a great time. Everybody's very nice.
When fans have had a chance to meet you this morning, what are the most common questions you've been getting?
When are you coming back? When are you coming back on the show? And do I still watch the show? Which I do on occasion. And you never know. I might come back in the show. Who knows?
Let's start with, the simple question. It's a show, Bones, obviously, that people love all around the world. Why do you think the show has had that kind of impact? Why do people enjoy it so much?
Why do people enjoy the show? Well, I think the cast is really good. I think all the other, you know, all the other actors are very, very good actors. And I think it has a nice balance between the drama and the crime solving and comedy. There's a really light touch to it. There's a lot of humor in it. I think people respond to that. And I think people like, you know, crime solving shows. And it's original in the way it deals with how they do it by studying the skeletal remains. And I'm just happy that people respond to my character, and that they really like the character. That's a real tribute to the writers, you know, who wrote something fun for me to play.
What do you think your character in particular is one that fans especially seem to respond to?
Gosh, I don't know. What's kind of fun about him is he's really smart, but he's also stupid. He's like smart about science type stuff, forensic anthropology, but then he can be kind of stupid about social things. Like in the first season, he even asked, what does take the hint mean? Like he didn't know what take the, what does that mean? What does that mean? Which is a theme of the show. What does that mean? It's what Zach says. It's also what Dr. Brennan says as well. I don't know what that means. I don't know completely, but I think they did a good job of writing a very kind of likable, fun person for me to play. When I auditioned for the show, the script kind of had a little bit of a bite for my character. It was a little bit, you know, sassy, snapping back at people. And I had fun doing that. But I think they felt like, well, he's not very likable. He's kind of mean. And I liked playing that. But I think they realized early on, like, we can't have this character be mean. We want people to like him. So they did a lot of good writing to make, you know, the character a very likable, fun character.
Fans will have their own favorite moments, their favorite episodes. Are there any in particular for you that you're especially fond of?
Yeah, people have asked me that. And I think my favorite episode was in the first season. It was an episode called The Man in the Fallout Shelter. It was a Christmas episode in which we all got locked in the lab for the Christmas holiday because there had been a virus released and they had to quarantine us. And it was just really sweet episode and very emotional and fun. And it was mostly just the main cast of the show. We didn't have many guest stars because we were all locked in. So it was really like a lot of interaction between us. And that just made it really fun.
Talking about the main cast, obviously, I think one of the show's greatest assets is the chemistry between the core cast. What do you think the secret of that is? Why does it seem to have mixed so well?
They did a good job of casting really fun people to be around. You know what I mean? I remember thinking when we were doing the pilot, I was like, the executive producer of the show, Hart Hansen, like, hires nice people. Not just the cast, but the crew and the other producers and writers were all really nice people. So I think that helps. We just all got along right from the beginning. They're all, you know, all the other people, Michaela, TJ, Emily, David, Jonathan, and then Tamara when she joined on, are just nice people that I still stay in touch with because they're very sweet.
I think obviously fans feel in some respects like we know these characters so well now. How close are people to the characters, the personas we see on screen, people like Emily and David, I guess, in particular?
What are they like? Yeah. Emily's not like her character at all. Emily is not, you know, someone was asking me, does Emily have, she said that Brennan doesn't have as much of a sense of humor. Does Emily have more of a sense of humor? Absolutely. Emily's very different in a good way. David, you know, Booth is kind of a lighthearted, kind of fun character. And David's like that, very kind of lighthearted and fun. They're both just very nice people, you know, that you want to hang around with. And, yeah, but I'd say Emily is different. Brennan can be very serious. Emily's smart, but she's not so serious and socially awkward at all.
You mentioned, of course, I mean, your character, he certainly knows his stuff when it comes to the science aspect of the show. I mean, is that difficult as a performer? Do you have to learn a lot of long, complicated words? And really, I mean, how much research goes in and how much is it just kind of repeating things parrot fashion?
It's repeating stuff parrot fashion a little bit. I mean, I learned some stuff, but my goal was always, I thought, well, there's no way I can, in a period of weeks preparing for the show, go to school and get degrees in forensic anthropology, you know what I mean? So I can't know everything. What's important is that I look like I know everything. So that's the most important thing, and I feel like I did a good job of doing that. And it was hard learning the words and memorizing them, but it was so much fun to do that it was never a chore. It was never work.
Talking about work, what are you working on at the moment? Where are we going to see you next?
The thing I'm doing right at the very moment is I'm doing a concert in Springfield, Oregon, which is where I'm from. And I've done concerts in New York and LA and DC because I'm a singer. In fact, I mostly started out as a singer, as musical theater. And so I've always done shows away from my hometown. And the people in my hometown have never seen me do like my cabaret show. And they've always asked for me to do it. So I'm really excited. I'm going to go back home and sing to everybody and sing with some of the people from home. And I did an operetta there a few years ago, but they've never gotten to see me just do, you know, my thing. So I'm excited about that. And I was in L.A., but I'm back in New York now and auditioning for theater and auditioning for television and hoping to find another acting job soon.
I hope you do, and we're very envious of the people in your hometown who are going to get to see the full repertoire. I guess my final question, do you have a message for fans, I guess particularly fans of the show out there, anything you'd like to say to all those wonderful people who love it and really hope you do come back at some point?
Yeah, I think they're all wonderful, nice people, and I'm so thankful that they respond to the show and that they've kept the show alive now for 8 seasons. And it's just really nice. Everybody was so nice. I mean, like I said, I've been smiling because I've been getting all these nice people coming up to talk to me. And I just thank people for being committed to it. And I thank people for staying committed to Zach, even though he hasn't been on the show. People haven't forgotten. And that's been nice. You know, I thought after a year or so, people would just kind of, you know, forget about Zach. And sometimes I go on the internet, look at a message board, and they're all like, when's Zach coming back? I think that's really sweet. So thank you, fans of Bones, for keeping the memory of Zach alive.